circuit board.
So here's a circuit board.
This is pretty typical of how a product will start, an electronics product that is. And as you can see, there's no components in the circuit board. All the traces are laid out and everything. All the holes are prepared for all the components to be put into it. And most Carvin products these days are taking advantage of surface mount technology. And the machine here is actually computer controlled, where it actually will take micro components such as resistors, capacitors, and so forth. And we're able to have the computers totally automated where they can actually insert, and they're tracked by a camera on the computer system here. So everything is lined up and quality controlled, where all of these components are sitting on the inside, which look like tape reader, and all the micro components are put into the board. The advantage of doing this is that a number of things. We can actually reduce the amount of heat that a product is generated. The larger the component, the more heat it will actually create. We can also reduce failure rate, because the smaller the product, the less heat that it generates, the less chance it will have for failure. We're also reducing the size of the product, because again, the number of components that will take to fit in a given space for a particular product has greatly reduced because of the size of the components on the circuit board. We also reduce the instance of potential solder points failing, because the smaller the component, the less weight that it has. Larger components, as you move a product around like an amplifier, it could have issues where the weight, if it's jarred in a transportation or something like that, the solder point could actually crack, and you would actually have a problem with your amplifier if you had a broken solder joint. So again, because these are actually mounted right to the circuit board, there's no components that are sitting high off the board. Now, we still use traditional components that are larger, and those are installed by hand, but whenever we can get into the surface mount components, we take advantage of that in the manufacturing process.
Awesome. I have a question for you. I have a Series 2 X100B,
right,
and it looks like a forest of things on the circuit board. Mm-hmm. I guess that was pre these machines here.
Well, there's still a number of products that are hand-wired. Some of the guitar amplifiers that are still doing the traditional tube technology, we're not really using any of the surface mount on those products, because we're trying to adhere to what the industry likes, which is a more point-to-point style,
right,
of circuit board when it comes to guitar amps. And so on the flip side of it, an amp like our SX200, which is a solid-state amp, doesn't use any tubes. So we're giving it the best of both worlds. It depends on which model of guitar amp you're talking about. When we're talking about more solid-state products, power amps and things like that, that's where these come into play. And they come in very handy when it comes to things that are very dense in components, such as mixers, where mixers have quite a bit of components. We're talking about the individual channels, and all the EQ and fan controls and effect sends and effect returns and everything that is incorporated with a mixer. You have a lot of components on the circuit board. And again, this allows us to make the product very effectively without having, a very heavy product that people can have to deal with when they're
awesome.
In a van.
Good stuff. Thank you for the demo on that.
Cool.